Hey guys, how's it going? It's Hero Collections here on behalf of Marvel Legends UK, and today we are looking at the new Walgreens exclusive Marvel Legends Moon Knight action figure from Hasbro. And I have to say, this is a stunning figure. If you don't already have a Moon Knight in your collection, this is the one to get. If you do already have a Moon Knight in your collection, this is still a must get. From the box art, to the accessories, to the updated articulation, it is a fantastic action figure, and Hasbro really hit out of the park with this one. What we're going to do is take a quick look at the box, then look at the figure itself, its deco, articulation, and accessories. In terms of where to get it and how to get it, this figure has released early in Europe, so in the UK you can now get it from Toys R Us. That's where I got mine from, great guys over there to deal with. It's also available from Superpower Toys in the UK, and I believe it's starting to pop up at some third-party suppliers in Italy as well. In terms of the US, when this guy does drop, you'll be able to find him at Walgreens stores. I believe it's not currently on shelves yet, but I think it was online for a period of time for pre-order. So check that out and see what you can do with that. But in the meantime, just taking a look at the window box packaging here in the front, if we turn it around, you've got the art on the side. And then looking at the back, the bio reads, "A vision in an Egyptian temple leads Mark Spector to don a shroud and become the crime-fighting hero, Moon Knight." So really cool looking box. Well worth picking up two of these guys to keep one in the box. So let's crack him open and see what we've got. So just quickly before we look at the figure itself, this is the inside of the box and it is so good. Typically, I think the backgrounds are usually just a plain color or, you know, a certain pattern of some sort, like space or something like that, depending on the character. But to have this for Moon Knight's box is a really nice added touch. So anyway, onto the figure. Okay, so here he is out of the packaging. What we'll do first is take a look at the deco, then the articulation, then the accessories, and some size comparisons. Getting a closer look, you can see the paint is quite a flat white. But just look at how it responds to the light and the shadows. I think I love figures that have that fun factor and have like an extra, you know, feeling or layer of an extra added dynamic. And this figure definitely has that. Again, it is a flat white pretty much the whole way down. But you get the sculpted calves here and the forearms. If you get a look at the fists, you get that crescent moon shape here as well. If we look along the belt, you've got the crescent moons all the way across as well. And you can really feel the texturing here with the paint. We've got the crescent moon on the chest. The eyes are very well done as well. Definitely feel like someone's looking at you from under there. In terms of the cape, you know how it is. It is a flowing plastic cape. From underneath, you do get a peg that goes into the back to hold it in place. But I like the way that you've got the sculpted wrinkles here and the way that it flows down. Mine does have a bit of a mark here on the back, but that's to be expected, I think, with the all white. But generally, it is a really nice looking figure. In terms of its articulation, if we turn him on his side, he can look forward and up about that much. He can look down about that much. He can look side to side. He does have a butterfly joint. He can go back about that far. Bicep swivel. Kind of double jointed elbows, just about. Yeah, I would say double jointed elbows. He does have a wrist swivel and there is a hinge at the wrist that moves down and up. It doesn't go up that far because of the crescent moon that's on the fist, but it does go up. He does have an ab crunch. He can go forward about that much. He can go back about that much. He does have a waist swivel. He can kick forward about this much. Thigh swivel. Double jointed knees. Boot rotation and ankle pivot as well. So I believe this is the Bullseye body mold, I think. Someone can correct me in the comments if it's not, but I'm pretty sure it is. In actual fact, If we get a look at Bullseye there, I'm pretty sure, yes, that is the exact same body mold. Looking pretty good. If we get a look at, let's say, Shang-Chi. For some size comparisons, I know I've skipped the accessories, but we'll backtrack. You've got Daredevil. We could use Luke Cage. Just to give you guys an idea of how this guy sizes up. Comparing him to the older Moon Knight. Now, the older Moon Knight came out in, I believe, 2017. As part of the first Spider-Man wave. So that was the Spider-Man Homecoming wave, the Vulture Build-A-Figure wave. And you can see he's a lot skinnier, but I think it actually works a lot better for him. He's sleeker, the articulation is obviously better. For this Moon Knight, you never got the butterfly joints, so that's a big upgrade for the newer one. We did get more sculpted parts, you know, on the gauntlet here, at the forearm, and on the boot, and a different kind of belt. I do really like the black and white look still. I still do really love this figure. If it had articulation in terms of the butterfly joints, it would rival this one better. But this one having that butterfly joint makes it a lot more fun, a lot more poseable than this one. And so I would probably say that's why I prefer the newer version. I'm sure we could probably get a re-release of this figure with this paint deco at some point, as we do have the head for it. But yeah, as I say, still a really great, this one still holds up, but this one still, the old one still holds up, but the newer one still wins this round. So in terms of the accessories, what we do have is the different head. So you can see the gray paint under there for the eyes, really nicely done. I'll switch those over in a second. We also have his staff. Now this is pretty good. It's not too flimsy, which is nice. Sometimes the weapons can from Marvel Legends can be a bit, you know, they can just warp in the packaging and that kind of thing. So it's nice and stable, so that's pretty good. He also comes with two extra hands. So these are open hands, trigger finger hands, whichever you'd like to call them. And then he does come with a number of crescent weapons as well. So they're pretty cool too. In terms of how the other head looks, it works pretty well. I think I do prefer the all white on the white body, and then obviously the black and white on the black and white body. But you know, I'm sure this could be an easy repaint for a lot of people. I might give it a go myself, but I'm sure that we'll get a newer version from Hasbro at some point in the black and white. But I have one gripe. This is an amazing figure, but I have one gripe, and that is, it's nothing too bad, but it's just a plastic cape, and it's nothing that a third party cape can't fix, and we'll go through that in a second. But looking at the figure, it's hard to really get it in the most amazing positions with the plastic, you know, and poses with the plastic cape. I mean, it's still doable, but the plastic cape just hinders it slightly in terms of how fun that playability is. You know, like that for example, it just, you want to get him in a nice crouching, ready to fight pose, but the cape just prevents that. So what we'll do is we'll put on a third party cape on him. But in the meantime, I do just want to show you guys how he looks with his staff. In terms of how the staff scales with him, really nice. Really, really nice. Again, that cape just slightly hinders how well he can pose and how well articulated he is. Without it, the cape, if we switch the heads back as well, just to give you guys an idea. Um, really poseable, really fun. Like, I really appreciate that fun factor. Something you can pose, that you can play with, that can just really be a lot of fun, really photogenic, that kind of thing. And I have to say, this figure is that. The cape does not help, but the figure itself is really good. So I'm going to run and grab a third-party cape that I had made for this guy, and we'll see how that switches things up. You guys can see, having that third-party cloth cape added onto the figure, it takes it from being great to just amazing. It adds that extra dynamic to it, that extra fun factor, the posability, because in this kind of a pose that I have him in, it's not practical to do that with the plastic cape. That's not to knock the plastic capes, because I know that in order to keep these guys at the, you know, Marvel Legends at a $20, £20 price point, Hasbro has to factor that in terms of, can we put a third party cloth cape with wire in it as well, versus the plastic cape. So if I'm honest with you, if I was to compare this to the Mezco, I do not own the Mezco anymore. But if I was to tell you based on personal experience, which figure is the better figure, is this guy right here. Simply because it is just so much more fun. And it fits in with your other legends. The scaling is great. The articulation is great. And by just having that extra touch of a cloth cape, it just looks amazing. It really takes it to the next level. Really well worth picking this guy up. I'm definitely going to probably be getting another one. We'll probably try that black and white repaint just to see how it looks. But let me know what you guys think. Make sure to follow us on Instagram at @MarvelLegendsUK_ and at @hero.collections. If you're in the UK, we do have a group, Marvel Legends UK. It's about 3,000 people on there now. Well worth joining. Even if you're in the States, it would be great to welcome you onto the group, or anywhere really. So let us know what you think in the comments below, and I will catch you guys later.